All right, y'all. Y'all see I'm a little parked, but we right here. We finna get it started. It's your boy, Must Be Me. We got the book again. Appreciate all y'all who's ordered the book already and those who are about to, or those who haven't thought about it. But you know you really want to. You know the website, mustbemebook.com. Go on and type it in right now on your little cell phones, your iPhones, your iPads, your tablets, your computers, wherever you're watching this from. Do your thing. Get it together. Get your copy. We gonna come together. Now, again, y'all know we've been in relationships for a minute because some of y'all don't get it. I'm trying to help you, but y'all want to ride around and do stuff that's not congruent to your life. Y'all don't even know what I just said, but we're going to leave that alone. Dig this. So I was thinking about something. Now that you got an understanding, you got a relationship with yourself, you know how you go to a job interview and they tell you, well, describe yourself in 3 words. What you should start doing is like, well, let me give you a description of myself, because 3 words confines you. If you ever heard of a fishbowl mentality, well, that's when a goldfish is in this bowl. It can't grow and it can't expand because it's only living life in this one genre, in this one area. It won't go out to another environment and grow. So as a fish grows, it has to be in a bigger bowl, if you get what I'm saying. Like, you have to move from this bowl to a 10-gallon tank, to a 20-gallon tank, 55-gallon tank, till it learns to go into the ocean. When you're in the ocean and you're free, you go wherever you want to be because there's nothing can constrain you. You can go from one end of the earth to the other, basically, underwater in the ocean. A lot of y'all would never know that, but it's true. So don't have that fishbowl mentality. Don't confine yourself to one word or be like, well, I'm hardworking. Okay, describe to me hardworking. Because if you doing something like I'm doing right now, if you sitting down at a desk and you typing, I'm sorry, I just can't see that as being hardworking. You get what I'm saying? Like, well, he work hard every day. The nigga sitting at the desk and he type. Ooh, I'm so tired of looking at this. Ooh, I work so hard. Your fingers might cramp up a little bit, but you physically ain't working hard. You might work a little bit mentally, but it's not strenuous. It's not anything going against the grain. So let's think about this. When you describe yourself to the person you want to get to know, don't give them one word answers. Tell them, keep it clean and cut. Tell them who you are, what you like, what you do and don't like, because you don't have to give them your whole biography and whole itinerary of your entire life. But what you do is let them know who you are and expect the same from them, because I'm not saying give them everything you have, but give them enough information to feed them, get them hungry, get them interested. You know how you have an appetizer before the food? So if the appetizer is good, you like, man, well, the appetizer is pretty good. I think this entree is going to might even be a little better. Give them an appetizer about you, a little taste test, so they understand, well, dang, I like the way he talked about this, talk about that. I'm not saying meet a person and be like, well, I want 7 kids. I want to live in a mansion. I want to own it. No. You just met them. Listen, I like to do this. I like to hang out. I actually go to basketball games. I enjoy the games. I watch the Bucks. It's one of my teams. I like these players, or I watch football. It's, I mean, not mediocre stuff, but simplistic stuff, just to give them a general idea of who you are. But don't talk about stuff that you don't do, because most of us got a propensity to talk about things that we really don't do. We want to seem like somebody else in front of her or in front of him and be like, well, yeah, I do this all the time. I do. Don't be compliant. Don't do something to make somebody feel good. Be like, well, she likes to go skydiving. Yeah, I go skydiving all the time. You ain't even jumped off the porch yet. You is not going skydiving. You jump off the curb, you mess around and break your ankle. So I know you ain't going nowhere over 2.5 inches in the air. Stop lying to her. Don't make her feel like that. And don't make him feel like that. Don't lie to him talking about, I cook all the time. Noodles don't count. Bread and butter don't count. You know what I mean? Hamburgers that's pre-patted already don't count. That's not cooking all the time. Nachos all the time don't count. So let's get an understanding. Tell them what you really don't do. I don't cook all the time. I cook sometimes. I like to go out to eat sometimes. Sometimes I just like a snack. See how simple that was? Keep it funky with yourself, because as long as you're keeping it honest with you, it's easier to keep it honest with anybody else. The whole gestures that you're giving off, or the whole aura that you want to give off the person, is genuine. You want to be you at all times. Not at nobody else's cost, or not at their ideas or their complexible ideas of what they may want you to be. Be you, because you can be nothing but you. I'm one of the people, if I don't know something, I tell you I don't know. Like, some brothers might run around and be like, you know, I do a little pimping or whatever back in the day. I ain't never known nothing about no pimping. You give me all kinds of hoes. My hoes be cheating me. They mess around and go and be to make 2 G's and give me $100. I'm like, girl, you got it in today. I might be excited. Like, yeah, she paid me. She got the rest of the money in her pocket, because I don't know nothing about that. So I'm not going to get into that field. So if you get to mess with people that don't want to expose a little bit about themselves, you'll never find out about more. So you got to be willing to expose a little bit about you at the same time. Think about this. Give off what you want. Remember we talked about that before. I can't say I want this woman with this physicality and all this other stuff if I'm not willing to be the same person. First, get yourself where you want to be. Then when you go looking for that, it's easy to find. And oh, I had to talk about it with somebody this morning. Now this confused me. Somebody was like, she not on my level or he's not on my level. Don't get me wrong, there are levels to life. But as in a relationship, or she's out of my league. I don't know who she played for. Because she looked better than most of the women you've dated or most of the women you've talked to, or you've never approached those type of women, or you've never approached those type of men. Ain't nobody out of your damn league. I don't care if they make $10 million a year and you make $60 an hour. That doesn't mean they're out of your league. It's all on how you present you. Because a lot of times, the most simplistic people make the best relationships because they don't expect much. Just because some people, I know people personally that have a woman that might make 6-7 figures a year, and he might only make 5. But the thing is, what he brings is so vital because he brings himself, or she brings herself. That's the most vital part of the relationship. You can't equate everything on how much you make or what they dress like at this time or that like at that time. Because brothers, we got a proclivity all the time to look at a brother and be like, well, you know, my guy be out here all the time. You know, he out here eating, he's shining, he doing good. You know, he riding all the A7, this and that. You know, he out here got the trues on of it. No. He ain't gonna make it. That don't mean he got money because he ride a nice car. He might have a bigger car note than everybody you know. He might be wearing them clothes. He might be going and putting stuff on layaway then to go get it. He might be smart with his whole situation. So don't just sit here assume he has this because of the way he comes off of what you see in the beginning. Find out who they are. Find out who you are. So now that you come together and make a union, once you each know who you are, there's nothing that can stop you. There, like they said, there's no limits to this guy. So there, it never ends. So you can go wherever you want to go if you keep it funky with you, keep it funky with them. So now as we're going to work on starting how to join a relationship, how to get into a relationship, man, I'm going to make it simple for everybody. If you see somebody you like or you think they cute or you might be interested in them, say hi. Say hello. I don't know why that's so hard for most people. Like, well, I didn't know what to say. What do you say when you greet most people? Hey, how you doing? Hello, I'm so-and-so. Hi, how are you? That's a greeting, right? That's an introduction, right? Well, damn, why you can't introduce yourself? Like, introduce yourself. Right on. Introduce yourself. Right on. Y'all remember that back in the day when you was young? You introduce yourself. You go up there clapping like, my name is so-and-so. Yeah, I am a Gemini. Yeah, come on. That's hey, if you want to get them started, get animated, that's how you get things going. But you got to introduce yourself. Let them see who you are. Get a conversation started. Where you want to go to conversation, that's how you direct it. Where they want to go to conversation, that's how they're going to direct it. So now you got to find a place where it comes along. You're congruent at the same times and it makes sense. So now, take these things I'm giving y'all, these little tidbits, it's going to help you out. Again, like I said, we keep it short and sweet today because we're going to grow a little deeper next week. But listen, remember I was talking about y'all, we got something fire for y'all? Listen! When I say it's the Lord's work, this is the Lord's work. These boys, oh my God. Y'all, when this next video come out, y'all gonna be like, y'all shouting out now, y'all gonna get the jump, y'all gonna be excited, y'all be running around telling everybody, like, I ain't gonna believe, y'all, oh my gosh. I'm still elated from yesterday. I'm still elated from how excited from when they got off yesterday on what they did. So I know how y'all gonna be. Y'all gonna be running around, skipping and hopping and doing dances, all kinds of good stuff. So listen, must be me, Chris Jackson, Author Chris, Chris Jackson YouTube channel, Author Chris Facebook page, www.mustbemebook.com, Grindhard Entertainment. We all here together. I'm telling y'all, come get your copies. And those who already got it, we set up a new platform, y'all. We're going to start inviting people because we're going to get ready to start a podcast. We're going to start people to come down and talk about what they felt and what they learned and gathered from the book. So those of you who already got your copies, hey, start leaving comments. Start saying, hey, when are you going to set up the podcast? Hey, when are you going to start having people on deck so we can come in and talk to you? Because we're going to bring y'all in. We're going to talk to you about it. We're going to keep it live. We're going to record everything. We're going to throw it out here in all these all different genres and different sites so people can see and talk about. But so it helps us grow, to help you grow, to help everybody else. Again, we're here to help you. With that being said, y'all know it's always love. There's much love, peace all the time. But this next one, y'all ain't ready. You're ready. Straight up.